that James Harden and that beard of his. Look, this guy's relentless. We know he's gonna attack the basket all night long. So I'm gonna make it my personal mission to keep that from happening. As long as we keep jumping those passing lanes, we can give them a run for their money. I know I'll be ready.
Are looking to defeat their Western Conference rival going into this game, bringing you another edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony, and on the sidelines tonight, Doris Burke. Take a look at the Jazz. They've lost their last three games, and guys, they like it. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Yes, a bit ago, Kevin McHale and I were able to catch up. He told me that he's looking forward to this matchup, their first look at this team so far this season. He said they'll look to play up defensively. As usual, their length and shot blocking a great deterrent inside. Kevin?
Terrific, Doris. Thanks, guys. What's your take on that?
You know, I think it's probably the way to go. The defensive approach suits their style and their personnel. So I think you go with it.
Yeah, and you stay true to your identity, and theirs is clearly at the defensive end.
And guys, Patrick Beverley, a perfect fit for the Rockets alongside James Harden. You know, Beverley is in that complementary role as a 3-and-D guy. And remember, also, even though he's the point guard, he doesn't need the ball to be effective. He's good at just spotting up the threes, and he's a hounding on-ball defender.
Honey, there's no luck.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
Here's Ingles, and Jones sends it back. Beverly against Hayward, and Beverly kicks to Thornton. And that misses. That would have put him up. For Utah, they've gotten 6 of 11 shots to go down so far. Pretty nice shooting. Got it. Nice one there from Exum.
I like the fact he had his head up immediately looking to make the dish down the floor. Get rid of it quickly.
They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. There's 45 seconds left in the first quarter, and the shot is good.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And watch, Clark, how the game plays out, because this is going to open things up on the perimeter.
Now, here's Beverly. He's guarded closely. Pass to Mateunas. And count the basket. He was fouled. And it's the Rockets with the ball. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing that last matchup with San Antonio.
You know, it seemed like once it went to overtime, the confidence from both teams just really seemed to go in opposite directions. And unfortunately for them, they were on the wrong side of that equation.
And, you know, Greg, that's the case a lot of times when we have an uneven matchup like that. I mean, the longer it stays close, the more the underdog starts to believe it can win.
Pairing up in the backcourt, Trey Burke and Alec Burks. Freak is out there with Hayward, and it's Gobert in at the 5 spot. That's the group right now for Utah. There's the pick. Hayward outside. Shot clock at 6. Inside, Freak. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up.
The past few weeks, you can see how Utah stacks up. seventh in blocks, seventh in field goal percentage. And they kept the lid on opposing teams' overall offense as well. They're in the top 10 in opponent scoring.
And going back to their block shots, they're fearless, challenging shooters and contesting everything. You end up on a few posters, but I love that willingness to take a stand defensively. And the Rockets have lost out on some free agent wars the past few years. They have remained competitive, but you wonder what could have been if they landed or kept some of those big names.
Kevin, I tell you what, when he gets to the rim like that, he's really hard to stop.
Yeah, he can get up a few notches higher, there's no doubt.
And that's how the game is played on the inside. You can play over the top. You've got a great advantage.
And with the Rockets, it's no secret that they take a very analytical approach to team building. Greg, you and I talked about that. And Clark, you know, you wonder if that hurts them in free agency.
Well, you know, when your front office makes no qualms about viewing players as simply just assets, it can be a hard sell to a free agent.
Hayward passes to Freak. And stolen by Ariza. Here's Walt.
Told you, Don Pagnotti always delivers. Brand Jordan Freak prototypes. Open the box, check them out.
Like Christmas and my birthday on the same day. Oh.